Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that we are studying topic significance of Tca cycle. When I say Tca cycle, it means tricarboxylic acid cycle. Now how is Tca and Krebs related? Let's study and find out. Tca cycle. If I say about Tca cycle or Krebs cycle, the significance or importance are many. Now Krebs cycle was a cycle of respiration that was started by Hans Krebs. Once the process of photosynthesis is finished, the cycle that comes into picture is your Tca cycle. Now Krebs cycle basically occurs in the mitochondrial matrix. As you all know that mitochondria is the place where ATP is synthesized, the powerhouse of the cell. Krebs cycle possess a compound that contains COOH group, that is basically carboxylic acid group. That's the reason Krebs cycle, or hence Krebs cycle, is also termed as Tca cycle or tricarboxylic acid cycle. The first stable product that's formed in Krebs cycle is citric acid. That is the reason Krebs cycle is also termed as citric acid cycle. Krebs cycle is a very common pathway for breakdown of metabolic products like carbohydrates, protein, lipid metabolism. All such can be broken by this pathway. The CO2 that's liberated during Krebs cycle or Tca cycle is used in photosynthesis. As we all know, that equation of photosynthesis is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, it gives glucose molecule. So CO2 is needed, and this CO2 is removed by the process of respiration in the Tca or the Krebs cycle. Krebs cycle produces 24 ATP. In simple, I can say it produces 24 adenosine triphosphates, and this 24 adenosine triphosphate molecules can be broken down into their intermediate products, whether it is ADP or AMP, and that high energy molecule phosphate can be used to gain energy source. Intermediate products of Krebs cycle also function as building blocks in our body, especially some amino acids or other organic acids function as a building blocks in our body. Significance, or you can say the importance of Tca cycle or Krebs cycle. Now when I say Tca cycle, it means tricarboxylic acid cycle. Tca cycle is also known as citric acid cycle, since the first stable product that is formed in the respiration process of Krebs cycle is citric acid. Also it is known as Krebs cycle because Hans Krebs was the scientist who discovered this cycle. The Krebs cycle has a wide importance in the process of respiration. Once photosynthesis is done, the Krebs cycle provides a common pathway for carbohydrate, protein and lipid metabolism. When I say metabolism, it means breakdown of all these food products which you intake as a food source. Its breakdown is initiated or started by Krebs cycle. The CO2 or carbon dioxide liberated in this process is very useful for the process of photosynthesis. As we all know that photosynthesis uses CO2 as a raw material to synthesize glucose as its food source. So respiration process provides the CO2 for the process of photosynthesis. Tca cycle or Krebs cycle produces 24 adenosine triphosphates molecule, which is an energy giving molecule. Krebs cycle occurs in the mitochondrial matrix, especially the ATPase machine where it is situated. Krebs cycle occurs in that, and also mitochondria is called as the powerhouse of the cell. So Krebs cycle occurs there to produce high energy molecule or energy consumption of the cell. The first stable product in Krebs cycle is citric acid. The intermediate products or the products that are formed in between the Krebs cycle, the succinyl-CoA, oxaloacetic acid, acetyl-CoA, all such products that are formed in Krebs cycle or Tca cycle acts as a building blocks for other organic acids to be formed. They can be used as raw material to form other organic acids, especially long chain of proteins, which is polypeptides, unsaturated, saturated fats could use some of these molecules to form their building blocks. Hence, it is known as amphibolic pathway. During Krebs cycle or Tca cycle, all the three different varieties of substances, organic compounds, especially like carbohydrates, fats, and lipids, gain entry, and it is broken down into simple form of organic compound. During Krebs cycle, the energy that's generated is obviously not equivalent to ATP. Or you can say not equivalent to photosynthesis energy. During photosynthesis, a lot of energy is generated, but it is somewhere on barter region or on the similar lines. Krebs cycle or Tca cycle, or you say citric acid cycle, occurs especially after the process of photosynthesis. The light reaction of photosynthesis and the dark reaction of photosynthesis, which is PS1, PS2, pigment system 1, pigment system 2, and Kelvin cycle, which takes place at the nighttime. After that, the process of respiration takes place. Process of respiration consumes certain organic compounds and produces ATP and CO2 that is used in photosynthesis or in photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 as well as Kelvin cycle. Students, I hope you all have now got a clear picture what could be the significance of Tca cycle or Krebs cycle. Thank you.